Another episode of IPN's Movie Night, where we share our love for movies good and bad. I'm Crowder Thomas, your co-host and head writer of In Pursuit of Nothing.
And I am Alexander Pasillas, creative director and the other co-host. Head creative director of In Pursuit of Nothing, not just like everything of In Pursuit of Nothing.
That felt natural. Sorry to interrupt you so much, but I'm just really reveling in the fact that I think I should be doing the introductions from now on.
We're co-hosts, Carter, so...
How many episodes have you introduced?
I think all of them?
Except for the one where you weren't
like
there?
Three of them. This is the third one. Something like that.
You gotta mix and match, man.
I know, I think we need to start
exactly. We're like a bag of Chex Mix. We gotta just...
you just get what you get.
Yeah, but there is another person here today. There's always another person here, except for the first two episodes. But Joel Lopez, another co-host for the previous episode, Dusty Doherty, co-host of the Fuck Ups Guide to Not Fucking Up podcast. Mm-hmm. He's also a filmmaker. He created like music videos. He edits. He does. But you do edit, right?
Yeah, I do edit. You're making me blush, man.
I'm not just fucking around with that, am I? Like, you edit? Okay. Okay. Yes.
I edit, film, write.
Yeah, just, he does it all. Well, Joel.
Not all good, but I still do it all.
I mean, what is good, right? You know what I'm saying? I mean, this podcast.
That is the question.
Is it good? Huh? I don't know. All right, well, Joel, welcome to the podcast. And you, never mind. I was gonna say, tell us a little about yourself. I mean, I just kind of did a little bit.
You did all my highlights. Everything else.
Yeah, I did the highlights. But I really wanted you to be on because I was on an episode and we kind of just talked about filmmaking a lot. And so I was like, okay, yeah, this is somebody I really want to get on just to.
Just, yeah, let's nerd out, man.
Nerd out a little bit. Just talk about movies because that's kind of just what we do, really. But you brought a movie. Do you want to tell us what it is?
Yes, it is one of my favorite movies as a kid. Big Trouble in Little China. And the reason I wanted to bring it up is because I have not seen it in a good probably 15 years.
Okay.
So
So part of me is like, I wonder if it still holds up for me.
You did ask us if we had seen the movie before, and then Carter, what did you say?
I haven't. I've always known about it. It's one of those I always remember seeing it in Blockbuster, like, because I went to Blockbuster every weekend with my cool weekend dad for like my whole life, and when the Blockbuster was open, we would go every week, and then I just always remember seeing it. I think the cover is really memorable. Like,
yeah,
So I always had this weird association with that movie, but I never wanted to watch it.
Yeah, I hadn't seen either. So it was one of those movies where I know about it. Like, I know the name, and it always just makes me think about like Chinatown. And so I think oh, this movie is like Chinatown or something like that. I don't know. It has China, the word, whatever it is, China. It has China in it.
Yeah.
And so I always get it confused. And I have seen Chinatown, so I don't know why the fuck I get it confused. But this movie was, we'll get into it, but it wasn't what I was expecting it to be. I didn't realize that Lo Pan was the character in this movie. I knew about Lo Pan. I didn't know about this movie. So that was.
Oh,
that's
really?
My...
I don't know about Lo Pan outside of this movie.
Lo Pan just has a very iconic look. No, that's what I'm saying. I've seen him in like pop culture references and I don't know, figurines or posters. And I'm like, oh yeah, his name is Lo Pan. I have no idea what movie he's from. I don't know, maybe it's from a movie called Lopan. I don't know. But that would that's my kind of backstory with it. Knew nothing about it.
I would like to give a quick fun fact.
Go ahead.
I was just gonna say Lopan is played by James Wong from Balls of Fury, which is a movie that I watched a lot and I'm ashamed of it. That's
okay.
My fun fact.
I've never been a guy who's been starstruck at all. Like I've seen a bunch of like big actors and I'm just like, oh, whatever. But I ran into him and I don't know, is it James Hong or James Wong?
Wong.
Yeah.
I ran into him in the theater of the one that's in oh my gosh, I can't even think about it. It's in by Beverly. Oh my gosh. The Farmer's Market.
Oh, New Bev?
No. Oh my gosh, why can't I think of that place?
Wait, in the farmer's the theater in the Farmer's Market?
Yeah, there's a big Farmer's Market in Mid-City.
Isn't it just like
Farmers have theaters?
No. Oh my gosh.
For
I'm
sale?
Wait, isn't it just
The Grove.
Yeah, isn't it just like an AMC?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's just a regular. I was happened to be there.
Oh, okay.
And I walked into a theater, see a movie, and there he is standing, and never been starstruck until I saw him. Because I'm like, oh my god, that's Lopan!
Yeah,
that's
did you take fucking get a picture with him?
No, man, I didn't. Ah. I was just like, I didn't want to say anything. You know, don't meet your heroes. I was like, oh, I can't say anything.
Respect.
Yeah,
those explicit instructions, don't do it.
Yeah, starstruck, like, it's funny because, like, you see someone you're not really starstruck with and you're just like, I don't care about getting a picture. But then you do see somebody and you're like, no, what if he gets mad if I ask for a picture? Like,
yeah.
So then you just don't get pictures with anybody. And they're all just stories.
Nobody believes me now.
Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, Big Trouble in Little China. As I was saying, it's definitely wasn't the movie that I was expecting it to be.
Okay.
This movie's a fucking trip, dude. Like, it there's so much to I mean, obviously John Carpenter, like, he's a master in what he does. Like,
yes.
You know, if you see a John Carpenter movie, you're like, okay, I know what I'm going into. I'm going to get, like, big animatronics, great visual effects, and just like a lively type of film. And this movie definitely was that. And then it was also a lot of other things.
Ooh, all right.
No, I mean, Carter, I kind of want to hear, like, your little bit consensus, because this movie, it is one of the, I'm glad that you say, like, oh, Joel, you wanted to watch this to see if it held up. And part of me is like, I don't know if it does in some aspects. So,
I agree.
Okay. But what do you think?
Well, it's tough. It's tough because I know if I saw it, like, I'd like it as a kid, but as an adult, I know that John Carpenter made the movie he wanted to make. Probably, I know that this one also had a lot of studio interference.
Yeah.
But it's just it's just not really my cup of tea. There's nothing like wrong with it, really. I don't have any complaints. I'm just like, the movie's just not for me.
Wait, what? Like, what about it? Why isn't it for you?
It's just like the cheesy action, like, comedy type of movies from the 80s. Don't really do it for me anymore. That's kind of what I mean. Like, you know, you can't. Police academies aren't good anymore.
True.
They're
True.
Not.
Okay. What?
You take that back.
I just
two is golden.
I mean,
but it was still, like, really well made and stuff, though. Like, it looked really good.
Yeah,
it was fine.
So I started watching this thinking, like, all right, it's been years. So I'm and a good friend of mine told me, so, like, I just saw it again and it does not hold up. So I was like, all right, I'm
glad to hear you say that.
I pressed play on this and I was hooked from the beginning to the end. So for me, I was like, oh my gosh, like, it's so good. This movie's so good.
So I mean, what about what
So
hooked
for
you?
me, what I liked is this old school kind of feel of let's forget all this fluff, let's go straight to the action. Within 5 minutes of it, we're at the
Yeah.
airport where the girl gets kidnapped, and then the rest of the movie is trying to find this girl. So it's like I didn't have 20 minutes of trying to build up anything else. It was just straight to it. And so I'm like, all right, I'm in the edge of my seat already. Let's go. Let's try to figure this out. And then everything that was happening was leading to something bigger. So like they try to find this girl,
Yeah.
they go to the alley, and they get to the alley, there's a big old fight happening. In that fight, there's Lo Pan and the Three Storms, and then oh my God,
Yeah.
everything just it just seemed like all right, every to get out of this was causing another problem. And so everything
Yeah.
just
Yeah.
seemed and
I think that was like when you're talking about like the alley scene, and that was when, and I'm assuming that was like when the rest of the audience knew that watched it for the first time, knew like, oh, this is what this movie is about, is going to be about, because that's when it just kicked into high gear with like the three, the storm, what are they called?
The Three
Yeah,
Storms.
the three storms.
They're just called Three Storms. Okay, cool. When the Three
Yeah.
Storms come down, like I was honestly very enthralled and shocked at how like well the visual effects worked in that, like with the lightning. I was like,
Yeah.
oh shit, this looks like not just for like a movie in the 80s, like now, this looks really good. And so I was
Yeah,
just like,
it does.
okay, this movie is going off the rails of what I thought it was going to. So,
No,
yeah.
but there are some silly things.
Oh, duh. Yeah, of course,
Yeah,
all
like
over.
the fact that the alley fight started with the gunfight, then go to a regular, fist fight it was just weird. Like they only brought enough ammo for the first round of shooting,
Oh, I know.
and now it's hand-to-hand combat, and it's just.
That's true.
But the thing I was laughing at is when the three storms come in the alleyway and they break out their weapons, they like the one guy has these knives and the other guy has the spinning things that's
Yeah,
spinning on his head.
which was like cheesy, but I was like, that's still pretty
Yeah.
sick. Like I was
But
just
I
like,
couldn't
oh man,
stop
that's
laughing.
spinning.
I couldn't
Spinning
stop
so
laughing at
fast.
the other guy who looked like he had two back scratchers.
Oh, yeah.
That's the first thing I thought of, and then they started moving really fast. I was like, ah, don't scratch my back. Rip the flesh right from my bones. But we never
It's
got to
and
see what those did.
they don't do
Did we
anything.
ever see
Yeah,
them in
they
action? You just
no.
you hit people with it.
Yeah, I guess they're just like
Yeah.
yeah.
That's
But yeah,
dangerous.
so that's when I knew I was like oh, this movie's gonna be a trip, and it was like, okay, that's right, this is John Carpenter, I need to mentally prepare for that, you know.
I do want to say that in the beginning, the very beginning where the guy's like interviewing that bus driver guy.
Oh yeah, what's I can't remember the
Egg
character's name.
Shen?
Yeah, is that the
Egg.
character's name or yeah, it's
That's the
Egg.
character's
His name is
name. Let me double check.
Victor
Oh,
Wong.
Victor Wong. Oh yeah, he's the grandpa from Three Ninjas.
Oh
Yeah.
my God. Oh my God. Next
Rocky,
week,
Tom
Three
Tom. Yeah.
Ninjas.
Yeah, he is in all four of
And
them.
all of them, yeah.
Like not even the
Oh my.
kids like reprised that many times, but he did.
But Grandpa needs to be in this.
But yeah. Oh, that's
No.
right. You're talking about, sorry, you're talking about the first scene.
Yeah. So I know I was reading that they added that first scene to emphasize Kurt Russell's character.
Yeah, Jack,
Yeah, to say,
to
oh
make him
no,
feel, yeah, feel
he's
more
a
like a
hero.
hero. Yeah.
Yeah, I know they had to add that scene later for
Yeah, that was
people.
like a studio request. Which
Yeah.
it is kind of funny because so not diving too much into it because we can get into it later, but that was the main thing I was watching throughout the whole movie. I was just like, Jack is does nothing. Like
He's a
Jack
dumbass.
could be
He's
out of
a
the movie.
dumbass.
I wrote multiple times in my notes, it's like, why isn't Wang the main character in
He
this
okay,
movie?
Wang is the main character, and
Okay.
even Carpenter would tell him, "You're the main character."
I know, but he's not. Like, and
He
that's the point, is that I've read so many things about John Carpenter being like, oh yeah, you know, all these action films where like the sidekick does more than like the main character, something like that. I wanted to make Jack like a bumbling idiot, essentially, where it's like later on when like they're about to storm the Empire, whatever they're storming, he like shoots the ceiling and the and a piece of rubble falls and knocks him out. It's great. Wait, what?
There's another fight scene where he goes to pull this knife out and it just flies away, and so he goes.
Oh yeah.
That was hilarious when he's like, ah.
No, but
Wang, like, handled all, he TCOB'd, took care of business.
Yeah, but that's but that's the thing, is that like, yes, he's, John Carpenter's trying to say that, he's trying to make that point. The problem is that he still did it. He still made him the main character, and even though he didn't do anything, in the eyes of the audience, he's the hero. Air quote hero. You can't see me, but I'm doing that.
I agree to a point, but here's where I would counter that is when they, I think it was like 3 years ago or 4 years ago, The Rock bought the rights to do the sequel to it.
Oh God!
And everybody was against this because they were saying Jack, like he's not a hero, he's the idiot, and The Rock is going to play him as the hero, and everybody was totally against that. Like, he's not supposed to be the guy that knows everything.
Right.
He's the guy that thinks he doesn't, or thinks he does, but he really doesn't.
Well, then they can just watch that version, then. I'll go watch The Rock.
You're true. Like, if people are on board with, like, yeah, he's supposed to be like the idiot, the thing is that he's still the main character, like regardless of how it's framed, of who does what better, he's still the main character. And that's why it's like, yes, you are making a little bit of a statement, but then just make him the main character and let's follow Wang's journey, and then Jack can just pop in and be like, oh, like, I'm just like muscle or whatever. I think part of it was also like, well, it's Kurt Russell, you know, like, we have to sell this movie, and he's like,
he was
like, his charm can cure cancer. Yeah. You know, so
they were thinking of getting Jackie Chan as
oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, I read that.
But and that he made a cameo in the alley fight, and I still can't see it. But
oh. Well, there's a lot
of
people
hear that.
In that fight.
See, yeah, no, so. I read that, John Carpenter wanted Jackie Chan, but the studio didn't want Jackie Chan because they thought the audience wouldn't understand his English. Yeah, so they were like, no. And then John Carpenter still asked Jackie Chan, but Jackie Chan said no.
Well.
So either way, Jackie Chan wouldn't have been in it, but isn't that fucking racist?
Yeah, but at least John offered it to him. Because that would have been... Wait, like, he offered him the role of Jack?
No, of Wang.
Of Wang. Oh. What the fuck? I mean, yeah, he still turned it down, but I was just like, what? Like, what? I don't know. Like, Jackie Chan's massive, and you're still worried that people aren't going to...
No, well, this is what, 84?
86.
I don't know if Jackie Chan is like, household...
Was he not household at this time?
Police Story had come out the year prior, and that was a pretty big hit. Like, I think that was like a worldwide phenomenon, because that's how John Carpenter, like, that's why he wanted Jackie Chan.
Oh, well, Story. I mean, I don't know.
It reached John Carpenter, so
that's good, I guess.
I don't know if he was like super household. Like, Jackie Chan Adventures hadn't come out. You remember that show? It was a cartoon.
It sounds familiar.
What? The Wendy's had like the Happy Meal rights. Anyway, different story.
I feel like you're having a Mandela effect right now, man.
Nah, we'll look this up.
I'm sure Carter's right. Carter has lived a different life than we have, Joel. So.
What does that mean?
I don't know. he's
Well, Joel, how old are you?
I am 39.
Okay, see, I'm 23. So.
Oh, okay.
He's also from Wisconsin, so.
All right.
Wendy's is everywhere.
I don't know. I don't know what that has to do with anything. That's just a known difference about you.
I just gotta throw this in. Cheese boy over here had a whole different life. He ate Wendy's. Come on. Let's get back to Kurt Russell.
Yeah, right. Kurt Russell, as I said before, his charisma can cure cancer.
Is that science proven?
Wait, what?
You said his charisma could cure cancer. I said, is that science proven?
Oh, no. This is my observation. He's, regardless of whatever I said about him being the main character, whatever, he's still so fucking good. And it's like he steals the show of like any movie he's in.
Yeah. I know you're against him being this bumbling idiot, but I feel like that was perfect for him.
Oh, no, I'm not against Kurt Russell being a bumbling idiot. I'm just like, I just wish that the movie was framed more in Wang's perspective rather than his. But
yeah, it's still, I agree with you there.
Yeah, it's still just like, I just watch him all day. He's so fucking good. Which is why he's the star, I guess.
But also, to be fair, Wang does come out almost every shot with him.
Yeah, he does. He does.
That's true.
Like, Kurt never really does anything on his own.
Yeah, it's except always, for ex- he's always except being to like saved infiltrate.
Yeah, yeah. Except when he had to like go in as Henry Swanson.
Yeah.
Oh, geez, it's raining cats and dogs out there. That was my favorite line. That was my favorite line in the whole movie.
Yeah, that was one of those things where, when I knew, I was like, everything he does is just so good, and it's just a testament to like the writing as well. Like, I doubt he was like ad libbing or anything, but
it's crazy
all of his lines were so fucking funny when he was playing that character.
It's crazy to me that this was gonna be a Western instead.
I didn't know that. What?
Oh yeah, that's a whole thing. You wanna talk about that, Joel?
Yeah, let's talk about it. Like, yeah, okay. I mean, you sound like you know more than I do. So, I mean, all I know is that the original script was supposed to be a Western, and instead of a truck, you know, that he lost, obviously, it was a horse that was stolen that he's got to find, and he was helping. Oh my gosh. I know it was a Chinese. I don't know if it was a Chinese immigrant or I don't. It was the same kind of thing where the Chinese guy was looking for his fiance
or fiance. Yeah.
Yeah, and what I was reading is that the two gangs in the alley were real gangs that existed in San Francisco in the 1800s.
Oh,
that's pretty cool.
Oh, I was gonna say, like, they were real gangs in the 80s that they just pulled off the street, like they like some fucking wire shit or something like that. But
the story kind of came from of people reading about these gangs from Little China or Chinatown in San Francisco, and
yeah, during the early 1900s or something.
Yeah, and that's why it kind of took place in that early 1800s, because you know, films, Westerns weren't doing good in the 80s.
Yeah.
That they switched it up. And they also made, I think the Kurt Russell character was more a badass kind of character, and they made him more funny instead of badass.
Like a Clint Eastwood type of character or something.
That's
like that.
That's who they wanted. They wanted Clint Eastwood.
Yeah.
Jack Nicholson.
That does sound kind of cool, but like, I mean, If they made that, they wouldn't have like the sweet 80s synth that they had during the whole thing. Like the music, I mean, you gotta admit the music's fucking incredible in this movie.
Yeah, that was by really him good. Too. That was by John Carpenter.
Oh, I believe it.
Oh, he made a music video for this thing, dude, and it sucked.
I think
John Carpenter composes all of his own music.
Yeah, if not I think
most.
So.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hold on. Let me go to his IMDb.
Dude, he's a fucking, oh my God. He's a fucking whiz.
He's good, man.
Yeah, I know.
Maybe it's not lately, but he's good.
Well, yeah, of course. I mean, he's How old is he?
He's really old. He is. He was born in 1948.
Oh.
So rather
70
old.
72.
You know what? So I'm gonna believe you. I'm gonna choose to believe you. My math is
50 is to 120 is 70 minus 2 plus 52. 72.
Yeah, he did the Halloween theme, and he also so like every Halloween movie has like him as a soundtrack as credit. Escape from LA, he did sick. The music for.
Kind of like Robert Rodriguez, he does the same thing.
Oh yeah, dude, all these fucking dude, sick.
apparently he made the music for the Grindhouse movies.
Oh, cool.
For Planet Terror, for just Planet Terror.
Oh, that's cool.
I do, because when we're talking about like Jack Burton being like this idiot or this idiot hero, I was trying to think like who else is this idiot hero, and what I found is like, Johnny Depp from Pirates of the Caribbean is like an idiot hero, and Star Lord from Galaxy of the Guardians is like an idiot.
Guardians of the Galaxy. Yeah. Well, yes, but they're the main character. Well, no, sorry. Well, Star-Lord is the main character, but like Johnny, like Pirates of the Caribbean, Jack Sparrow. Like he's not the main character. And I think a lot of people see that's weird though. That's a weird like comparison, because people think he's a main character and he's not. Like he's most definitely not the main character.
True, but at the time, who's the only character you wanted to see?
Yes, of course, and that's one of those instances where like you made a side character that is better than the actual main character. It's like the Minions, you know. You make you make like a really really cute and good side characters. Doesn't mean they deserve their own movie.
True. Wow, so you just crossed a line. Just kidding, Minions are garbage.
Okay, but let's talk about the animatronics and like all the puppetry and all that in this movie. I mean, it's very classic John Carpenter.
It's very classic. I have
what?
It was super good. Sorry, I yawned when I said that.
Wow. Okay.
I have a love hate with animatronics.
Wait. Like, what? Why?
I love what they could do for the time. But as we're more involved, I think I do love, you know, like you could see how fake it looks now.
I mean, yeah, I think you can see it like when you watch older movies. I think like even now when they use animatronics in movies today, like with like, you know, better technology and better you know, advancements, it like some of it, sometimes it's like that, it's really impressive. I think it's just just in general, like the limitations that they had while they had to like hide it. It still like looks good for like that time. Like I don't know why I keep thinking about the, I don't remember where they were, but there was like this giant spider in this movie that just like came out of nowhere.
They came out through that hole. And then...
Yeah. Like that was where I was like, holy fuck. That's like, and that was hardly in the movie, and they built that entire thing just for that one, like one or second. Two shots. So I don't know. It's always just like the go full force into this, you know?
Yeah, I mean, I do love that floating eye or the floating thing with all the eyes.
Yeah.
Oh god, yeah, that thing was gross.
No, and then like it opens its mouth like it's talking, and there's still just like another eye in it.
Another
eye.
Like,
what the fuck? I don't know, like that thing looked all too
disgusting,
too realistic, but also not. And it was just in this weird, uncanny valley type of situation. Like it has a real face, but it's a floating orb. So yeah, that was
also we. Sorry, I feel like I'm all over the place with this because feel like we also we ignored the fact that one of the storms, the lightning. Was straight like that's like we got to know that Mortal Kombat that was influenced
Yeah,
Mortal Kombat was influenced by that movie.
Yeah, I think it 100% was. Like, I mean, reading some trivia stuff, they said like the Three Storms were partly, I should say, the inspiration for Raiden and stuff. Which it's like you think of Raiden and you just, or you see them and you just think of Raiden. Like that's all I can really think of.
That's all I see now too. Yeah.
Yeah, that's that's like the first thing that popped into my head too. I was like, oh.
Yeah, it just sounds like something from Mortal Kombat, just like their look and everything. It's like they have this like Kung Lao type of look with their hat, but
yeah,
you know, have like power,
but also,
like Raiden.
Also the lightning, like what a powerful tool to have to never use.
Yeah, right?
He uses it as a pole to come down from the sky. He's just like, whee!
That's his Mary Poppins.
He shut a hole in something, didn't he? Or he destroyed some, I don't know. He did something.
There's a scene towards the end. Yeah, where they're getting away, but he's shooting every wall except the wall they're at. He has horrible aim, or
just because he has lightning powers doesn't mean he doesn't suck at using it. Like
he's indecisive.
Yeah, he's indecisive.
Yeah, that was like another. It was because I know what part you're talking about is like near the end fight scene. It was like a little trick that I saw, how they made it like realistic, how they sold the lightning, and. It's just one of those things where when you see it, you're just like, fuck, I'm not thinking about film in the way I should be thinking about it. But like when he's using the visual effects, he's using the lightning and it just like he's just like charging it up with his hands or whatever. They have this light that they shine on him on like from below or something like that to light up his face. And you can tell that like when they were shooting it, it's like, OK, obviously he's not actually holding lightning, but they're still lighting up his face like it is there. And I was like, that is such a small detail that completely sells the effect. And I need to like incorporate those details when making something like that. Because you can't just like have lightning there and then just, you know.
You know what I used to do, which you guys probably know this with you guys being filmmakers also, is whenever I shot a scene of somebody like shooting the gun, I would avoid showing the muzzle flare. Because I was never good at like compositing that. But I would put it where you saw the end of the gun and then the whole arm, you know, extended. And I would take a flash picture of them. And so the flash picture acted as like the muzzle flare that, you know, from the gun, but it's like flashing on his face.
See, that's smart. And no, we haven't done that.
It works, man. I'm telling you. The only problem is timing.
Like you would just use timing. A picture of like the spark.
No, I would literally just take a picture of the guy.
Like you would have that go off at the same time that the gun is supposed to go off, at their face, so it looks like the muzzle flash lit up their face, and that is that's so smart because in the video movie night. This podcast is called in our video movie night where Max fires off a gun, I had to like do this mask thing to light up his face so that it looks, and I just did like a, I don't know, use brightness and mess with the colors to make it look like it lit up his face and everything around him, but it's just like it was one of those like it kind of sells, it kind of looks realistic. That would have been a whole 10 times better if I'd used that trick. So that's a good trick.
It's cool, but it's also timing. You got to get their hand action timing with the flash. That's the only problem that I ran into, but yeah. That reminded me of just lighting his thing when he was doing the lightning.
But that's just good filmmaking too. It's just, that's a good director and good, details that, you know, someone like John Carpenter pays attention to. God, I can't speak. Ugh.
You're just in so much awe you can't even speak. I understand.
Yeah, totally. What else about this film did we like or not like?
I was just gonna say I do like the sense of fun and adventure that it has. I like that it doesn't take itself too seriously.
Yeah,
like I did enjoy that, and I'm trying to think of like I didn't really like, I did, well, not that I didn't like, I didn't find really a necessity for the journalist character, Margot.
Yeah.
I agree.
I
Yeah.
thought she was kind of, I thought she was just kind of pointless to the whole thing. But I get that Kim Cattrall, whose character's name I don't remember, but that she needed to like have a friend, I guess. I feel like she could have just been on her own.
Yeah, but did she? Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, did she need a friend?
I guess because like she needs to get the story out about
Yeah, I guess, yeah.
this underground Chinese sorcerer who's cursed.
Yeah. I don't know. Yeah, her character is really weird. It didn't really provide any
Anything really.
tension or anything like that.
One thing that I did like, and it could, it could be nothing, but I liked how they portrayed, and I'm forgetting the names right now. Is it Wang?
Yeah. What
Wang, yeah.
the little See, I was gonna say
Yeah.
sidekick because he's the sidekick
Yeah, but
in
also
the movie.
him and the other guy who was the maître d' of the
I think it
restaurant.
yeah, I think it was Eddie.
Eddie.
Yeah, he was like the
Here,
it's the I don't know what
here's what
else
it,
he was.
here's what I liked about it is that I think it's very easy or very typical for Hollywood to say, well, you're Asian, let me have you speak with an Asian accent. And I
Yeah.
like that they didn't. I like they said, you know what, you've been here, like you have a different accent. And I
That's
like that
true.
maybe the older people were first generation Asian, first generation Americans, and so they had a little accent. But I like that they changed that. Like,
I did appreciate that as well. That's one of those things I didn't really think about because it's like you don't like that's not a detail that you just think like, oh yeah, they're from America, they have American accents, but you don't realize
right.
that movies tend to do that. Like movies tend to like stereotype Asian characters and everything like that, and it's like no, they spoke very well. You
Fluent,
know,
yeah.
they weren't stereotyped at all. Besides the fact that it was like, you know, like besides their Chinese culture, you know.
Right. And that they actually hired Asians.
Yeah. Oh yeah. You know, if this sounds really nitpicky, but during the whole fight scene, like the one in the alley, I kept thinking like, all right, where's the hidden white guy? There's gotta be a hidden white person in there. And I was like, nope, they're all Asian. Okay.
Now,
I mean,
I don't know if you guys watch a lot of 80s movies at all.
I had a stint with 80s movies in middle school.
Okay, there's an Asian guy that walks by the truck right before the big fight. And I don't know his real name. I should know his real name, but I call him Nindu because Nindu was his name when he was in Lethal Weapon.
Mindu.
Oh, the first
And
one?
he's like yeah, the first one. He is like Danny Trejo for like
Really?
background actors. Yeah. He is in every he's in Die Hard, he's in this one, he's in now I'm going blank.
Lethal Weapon, the one
He's in
he's.
Lethal Weapon. Like
I knew I
he's
recognized him.
always the one of the henchmen for the bad guys. And I
Oh
was
my
like,
God.
oh yeah, it's so every time I saw him, every time I see him, I'm like, yeah, just the way I see Danny Trejo, I'm like, yeah.
Yeah. You're getting work. That's
You're
great.
getting work.
I mean, in the 80s, not, I mean, I don't know about now, but
True, true.
yeah,
But
I
yeah.
think my other than what the thing I was just saying about like the main characters of, I didn't have any major qualms with the movie. Like
Me neither.
it was just really fun, and it's one of those movies that, you know, you watch to have a good time, and you watch with
Yeah.
friends, and it's just you can turn your brain off. It's funny, it's, you know, like there's
Yeah, you
so
can't take
many.
it too serious.
Yeah, and it's clear that they knew that or John knew that that was the movie he was making, so.
And I also feel like this is a movie only for its time because, like, I don't want a remake. I don't want a even a sequel to this. Just like let it be
Same. Just let it
done.
be its own thing. Yeah.
Yeah. And let it be done. But also, we need to talk about the video game fight that they had. I forgot about that.
Oh,
Wait.
with they made the laser come out of their fingers and then they
Yes.
were I was like, what the fuck are they? I'm like, just
Their
fight for
hands are
real.
their hands are like they're moving around like they're playing video
Oh, I almost forgot about that. I remember seeing that and being like, what the fuck is this movie doing?
I
like
think
that I might have shut that out of my head because I was like, what the fuck is happening? Like, it's still
they missed a
badass, but
real.
I was just, what the fuck?
I think they missed an opportunity for after that happened, Kurt Russell should have looked in camera and said, "Now that's what I call a thumb war." And then he could have like just walked off.
Well, Carter, it's a shame that you weren't in the film
We need to
industry
rewrite
during this
it. I
time.
guess you know what? I stand corrected. We need to refilm this
Yeah,
movie and put in those lines.
let's call The Rock and have him hire you as the writer for Big Trouble in Little China 2.
I'm working on the email right
Electric
now. Dear Mr. The Rock, I hope
Boogaloo.
this email finds you
The
well. I love Skyscraper. I don't have a spec script, but I have a line. Yeah.
He knows you're lying, man. Nobody likes Skyscraper.
it's like, oh, you're
Oh,
right,
this is a
delete this guy.
hoax. This is a hoax.
Sorry, I meant
Rage.
Race to Witch Mountain. yeah, there's a lot of trivia on this. I'm like trying to like see if there's anything. Oh, apparently, this is just a little side tangent. I feel like I don't know if there's anything else that we talked about that we want to get into before we kind of start wrapping it up. But
Oh.
apparently the vehicle that Egg drove in the movie, apparently that is still active, like that
What?
vehicle. Yeah, I read
What?
that the vehicle Egg Shen drove in the movie was a 1936 white touring car. That car is now in Yellowstone National Park, the location for which it was originally built, named Hollywood, and gives tours out of Old Faithful. I was like, that's sick.
What?
I want to go there now just to see
That's
that.
sick.
So I was like, that's a cool little tidbit that if anyone is curious, they can go see it.
Yeah, that's crazy. I read some
All
fact
right.
that that Kim Cattrall didn't have green eyes, so they had to give her the contacts. And back then,
Really?
those con yeah, back then those contacts were like glass, so it would hurt her. But I'm like, she wasn't even a big name at the time, like. Why not just cast a girl with green eyes?
Oh, she was in Police Academy, bro, and that shit made tons of money.
I believe you said that those movies suck.
Well, yeah, what the
That didn't
fuck?
mean it didn't make a ton of money.
Yeah.
And
You know what?
they
She
do
was in
suck.
a movie called Mannequin, and I don't know if you guys know about this, but hold on to your seats. You got to watch it.
Okay,
Wait,
what's
what's
that?
it
That
called?
really Mannequin.
Mannequin?
Yeah, it's about a guy who she's like a mannequin, and then I don't know what happened, but she comes to life, and then he starts a relationship with her. I'm telling you, it was so good that they made a sequel and nobody came back for
Yeah, no,
Well, oh my
nope.
God,
I'm like looking
this
up
is a
pictures. I
movie.
don't have no idea what this movie is.
It's horrible. It's horrible.
Okay,
It's
yeah,
horrible.
she really doesn't have green eyes. That's fucking weird because I would have never thought that those were contacts. I mean, I
Yeah.
obviously like, I mean, if like what you said, like, oh, they're glass contacts, dude. Fuck that. If I was her, I'd been like, I'm not doing this fucking movie if I'm putting that shit in
Yeah.
my eyes.
I was
Why
reading
didn't they
the
just
and they
change it in After Effects later?
Yeah, yeah, why not? It's so easy.
Idiots.
You live and learn. Live and learn, man. John
Yeah.
Carpenter, he just doesn't understand that.
And
There was one thing that I found funny. I guess not funny, haha, but like that's weird. Is I was noticing that Wang was getting his butt kicked every fight until the 57th minute. Then all of a sudden he could take on like 13 people at one time.
okay.
You know, I think that was a very interesting character development move on John Carpenter's part. He's like, he's gonna be not so good, but now he's gonna be really good.
He's gonna be really good. Yeah, man.
Yeah, that was, I mean, that was kind of weird though, because I didn't even see that like transition, like realizing like, oh, he's not like that great of a fighter, and then all of a sudden he is. Part of me is just like, yeah, he's always been a great fighter. Wait, what? Like, I didn't even think about that. The movie just had so much going on that that thought didn't even pop into my head.
That for 30 of my years here, because I probably saw it when I was 9. Or it came out in what,
86.
84,
86.
86.
Yeah.
I probably saw it when I was 6, and I never even questioned it until now. And now I realize, like, wait a minute, he's getting his butt kicked all over the place every time. And it's after they jump into that pool and they go through the tube. When he comes out of that tube, from that moment on, he could fight. So
Wait,
something's
didn't
in the
they drink
water.
that? They drank that juice though, right? They drank
No,
that
they drink that
special
juice
juice.
after, or they drink that juice later on into the movie.
Okay,
Because
okay.
when they jumped into the water and gone into the tube, that's when he has the big fight scene where Kurt Russell comes back yelling and
Oh, you're right. You're
everybody's
right.
all knocked out. Yeah. So it's
Yeah,
like
yeah,
whatever's
yeah.
in that water, he got it, and he got the one ups.
Yeah. Can we also talk about really quick of like when Thunder explodes?
Oh
Like,
my
why?
God.
That
Dude,
was one of the
I was like,
ones.
what?
Yeah. That came out of nowhere and I was just like that was almost unwarranted. Like I was like, what the fuck just happened? He just saw like Lo Pan dead and he was so upset that he exploded.
Yeah.
So
His feet got to the size of like boulders.
just quick, and it actually is funny because like I've seen that frame before of him like stretched out and like before he explodes of the animatronic, and I was just like, you know, now it's kind of cool now that I can put a movie to that picture. But I was still just like, that's uncalled for. Like sometimes
That's
John Carpenter
uncalled
stuff
for.
is like, that was excessive. Like I'm gonna be
Yeah,
honest, that was excessive.
I remember even as a kid, I was like, but why?
Why, Papa?
Why though? It's like
Why did you blow up?
yeah, you can still fight them.
Yeah. Also,
No, he
another
gave up.
yeah. This I think when Lightning gets a Buddha statue thrown on top of him, the
Yeah.
little Chinese characters that in
Yeah.
electricity that comes out spells out or says Carpenter.
Yeah.
Transit carbon. I was like, oh, that's kind of cool. That's a cool little
I didn't notice that until when I saw that movie this week. And then I was like, was that there the whole time?
I didn't notice it either until I saw it this week.
Was like,
Okay.
wow.
I didn't notice it at all.
Cool.
Wait,
All right.
until the next time you see it, buddy.
Oh, that's never gonna happen.
Right. Well, we usually like to rate our movies on here. Not that it really fucking means anything. It's like
Is there an
there's so
11?
much.
Is there an 11 for this?
Did we do that for Spinal Tap, Carter? Did
Should
we do
have.
it out of 11?
I think,
Because
well, that's because that's a thing in the movie. If you give this movie an 11, I'm gonna have to hit you. Just kidding.
I
Give it a 12.
don't know. No, we don't do 11s here. That's cheating. Why don't we start with you, Joel? What's your rate
It's
of this
unfair.
movie?
I'm a little biased. So, if,
That's
what
fine.
what's the rating? What's the rating system? Like, is
I
it
mean,
1 through
just
10?
out of 10, like, you know, when you think of it, like,
For me, because I'm entertained, it did its job for me, and it added my nostalgia. I give it an 8.
okay.
Word up.
Okay,
Word
that's
up.
respectable. I would give it yeah, like a 7. I was like, because I don't like to do like 0.5s. I don't like to do in betweens. I like to just be straight up with a number, and it's like it's in between 6 and 7 for me. So I was just like, fuck it, I'll just give it a 7, because like I said, it did its job. It knew what it was, but it overall didn't
Impact
didn't
you.
like. It didn't obviously like say anything, and there was like some weird character things. Obviously, I've talked about it enough, so that was my only thing. But I mean, it's a fun movie. Like I can't deny that. So,
Yeah.
That's me.
And I give it a 6 for those exact same reasons.
6, 7, 8. There you go.
Look at that.
Because 6, 7, 8.
I was going to say.
sorry, what, Joel?
Do you guys like Carpenter at all? Or?
Yeah.
Like John Carpenter? Yeah. I love Halloween.
Yeah.
And what was it? What was the Mars one with Ice Cube?
What?
John Carpenter made a movie with Ice Cube where it's like a Mars fight. Hold on.
With Ice Cube? Red? Red Planet? What?
Ice Cube? Like the rapper?
Yes, like Ice. Yes. Yes. The rapper. Ghosts on Mars.
Ghosts on Mars. Oh!
Wait, he made that?
Yeah, see, dude, John Carpenter like co-wrote and directed that movie. And to be honest, I've never seen it, but it's like everyone says it's his worst film. And I'm like, well, I've got to see it.
Okay. Yeah,
I'm going to tell you guys that is going to be blasphemy from anybody who, you know, who thinks they're filmmakers are going to say like, "Oh, that don't ever say this."
Okay.
But I'm telling you, I love The Thing.
I heard The Thing is great. I've heard
don't
it.
Most filmmakers love The Thing?
Yeah, most filmmakers love The Thing. Here's what I'm about to tell you.
Okay.
The Thing that was made in 2011.
You think it's better?
No, but watch it back to back with the old one. Watch the new one first, and then watch the old one. And that movie plays like a 3-hour one-off movie.
Okay, that's what I've heard. I've heard that like. The one thing that made the prequel thing,
yeah.
The one thing that kind of people shat on it for is that there was like a lot more visual effects rather than practical effects, and it kind of took away what made The Thing great.
Yeah,
and I've heard that like other than that, it's actually like a pretty decent movie. Like,
yeah, like I don't know if you guys seen The Thing, but it starts off with a dog with a helicopter chasing a dog, and you're like,
oh yeah,
why?
I've seen that.
And you really don't understand why, and then the and people think it's a remake, and it's not a remake, it's a prequel.
Mm-hmm.
But when you see the prequel, that's how it ends, and you understand why.
Yeah.
And so if you watch it just straight through, it's like it was like a 3-hour movie that's just perfect. It was great.
I remember like reading about that as well. I haven't seen the 2011 one, but I think my only combatant with that would be that if you did do that, then I mean I know you already know it, but like everything in the beginning of the thing would just mean that like, okay, you know what's going on, when a lot of it comes out of like the fact that you don't.
True.
And it comes as a surprise, so it's like it's like trying to watch which order of Star Wars, you know, like knowing the twist of Darth Vader. It's like, how do you watch?
Wait, what?
Like, so it's like, if you, people are saying,
what
twist,
like, what twist with Darth Vader?
Oh, he's really James Earl Jones.
I'm not even going to fucking play with that, Joel. it's the whole thing, like, I know, like, most people already know, even if they haven't seen Star Wars, but it's the whole thing, like, okay, if you watch it chronologically, like you shouldn't watch it chronologically, because then the twist of Darth Vader being Luke's father, it means nothing. So like for someone who hasn't seen it, like they say a good way to watch it is like watch A New Hope and Empire Strikes Back, and then watch the prequels, and then finish with Return.
True. So that's like, huge. That's way too complicated. I'm gonna watch one set first.
but that's what I'm saying. It's like how do you like, what's a proper watch it to keep like that suspense of no one has. I mean, everyone's heard of Star Wars, so it means fucking nothing to really be like, oh, well, it matters how you watch it. It's like, no, it doesn't, because everyone knows everything about Star Wars. So, sorry. my little tangent about Star Wars a little bit.
I'll tell you this. Like, for me, I love I don't care about spoilers.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, I'll tell you, for me, I never watched I used to never watch Game of Thrones. And the very first episode I've watched of Game of Thrones was Red Wedding. I don't know if you guys watch it.
Oh, why did... Oh.
So I just happened I just happened to be there, and I see this episode of the Red Wedding, and I'm like, I am hooked. I want to know where these characters come from. And so I rewatched, or not rewatched, I just, it started hooked me more.
At the beginning.
Yeah, and wait, I just started it up, and I enjoyed it more. For me.
Like the Red Wedding, like the, I'm making sure I'm like remembering the episode, right?
Yeah, that's the one
that I think happens, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's the one where,
dude, that one I was like, I don't know if I like this show. And I'll tell you what, I don't.
I was watching it with my brother and sister, and their faces were like, oh my god. And I'm like, interesting. I've got connected to these characters, but I'm like, I'll try it.
It was one of those like excessive. I know you're HBO, but excessive. It's too much. I don't know. That's me.
It's on you.
Well,
I've never watched Game of Thrones, so I can't. I don't have an opinion.
You don't have to, Carter. It's fine. don't give in to people like, oh my god, it's like the greatest show, even though I was saying like early on, we're on a tangent, I know, but this is what we do.
Oh, I'm all Andy.
I knew that the last season was going to be dog shit. Even before hearing anything, I knew season 8 was going to be horrible because season 7 sucked. And people were like, what? You didn't like season 7? I was like, yeah, it was garbage compared to everything else because they forgot what they were making. Yeah. So I didn't watch season 8 because I was like, I don't need to. I know it's going to be horrible.
You know what's funny is that I didn't like season 8 for a different reason. Like everything that happened, I already knew that was going to happen. Like you could just pinpoint like, I know, at this part, like I knew from season 5 who that bad person was going to be at the end. You know, I don't want to say any names or anything, but they're turning. And I'm like, I just wasn't surprised. And yeah, it just was like, all right.
It's Daenerys. Carter, you don't care. You're not going to watch it. It's Daenerys.
You don't need to be forced to watch this.
I know.
I'm not. I'm not going to watch it anytime soon.
I'm just telling for the people who are listening. I don't care. Like I don't care about spoilers either. I'm like you, Joel. It doesn't ruin anything for me. In fact, sometimes like I can pay attention to a movie better if I know the spoilers. But I don't know.
Yeah.
I am very particular on spoilers. Usually I don't mind them, but then there are like certain things I don't want spoilers for. Like I watched Hereditary recently, and I saw a TikTok that spoiled a really important part of that movie, so it had less of an impact. Huh?
Was it the
when her head?
Yes.
When her head got chopped off.
Yeah.
Yes.
Did I just spoil it for everyone else?
No. Now
we've ruined it for everyone else.
No, I haven't seen it, so I knew about that.
It's incredible,
though.
Dude. Incredible.
Dude, I'm gonna watch it. Don't worry.
No, I know, but I'm still like, I watched two bomb ass movies, Incredibles 2 and Hereditary.
Such an opposite end of the spectrum there.
Dude, the Incredibles 2 is amazing.
Incredibles 2 is like, so like good.
This animation, colorful kids movie to this dark horror movie.
I wouldn't even say it's a horror movie. Well, that's a different discussion.
Yeah, we'll get into that. But thank you, Joel, so much for being
on.
As you can tell, we do this a lot, where it's like we'll get on tangents because you know you can tell like who likes to talk about movies. And
yeah,
you know.
I don't get to do that enough. I'm fucking love it.
Yeah, well, you're welcome back anytime.
Let me know. I'll pick better movies for you guys.
Wait, what, Carter?
I was going to say, it's off topic, but we always tell the guests they can come back whenever. It's like, we need to have a guest who we say, don't ever, you're not allowed
don't
back
ever
on
come
this
back.
Show.
No, Joel can come back. I think, Zach can never come back. Okay.
Zach can never come back. Okay. Zach, you're banned. You're banned from the show.
But yeah, is there anything that you would like to plug, Joel? Plug to the 5 people that listen to us.
Hey man, you're there with us with our podcast,
which is called
The Fuck Up's Guide to Not Fucking Up.
See what
we
I did
basically
there?
just talk about different fuck ups in life and then teach you different things about how not to fuck up in
Yeah,
your life.
it's very nice because like it makes it very relatable, you know. It's nice to be like, oh, okay, cool, I'm not alone.
You know what's funny about it is that every time we're thinking of an idea to talk about, we realize like, man, we fucked up a lot. Like so far everything we said, like, yeah, I got a story about that, or I got a story about this, about fucking up. I'm like, man, maybe we should take
Yeah.
our own advice. But yeah, follow us on Instagram at f_ups_guide. That's it. Other than that, man, just watch movies and have fun and have conversations.
Yeah, seriously. And they made a you also have a website, Joel.
I do, and you know it would be cool if I knew offhand what that
What?
website was. I know it
What?
is. It is voicebox.hq.com.
Voice with how's voice spelled?
It's VOIZBOXHQ.com.
Yeah,
Here,
go to that
here's what you guys have to understand is that we have different we set different jobs for all of us here. I'm in charge of the Instagram, so I know that offhand. Dusty's in charge of the website, and so I'm not really paying
Oh.
attention to that as much.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. But yeah, like you can check out their stuff there. You can hire them if you want. They made a kick-ass
Yeah,
movie
man.
for Matthew Jerry called Wake Up. Dude, it's so sick. Yeah, fucking go
Yeah,
there.
we're in production and doing a little short film right now, but dude, if you guys ever wanna meet up, dude, we could just shoot some films, shoot
Hell
something.
yeah. Hell yeah. We're definitely
Yeah.
gonna do something like that. Sweet. Carter, do you wanna plug?
My Instagram's CarterWBT. That is also my Twitter handle. I would go for Twitter. I'm way more active on there. But that's also set on private, so you're not guaranteed a VIP pass.
All right, cool.
Wait, 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 wait. Carter.
WBT.
Gotcha. Yeah, gotcha.
Dina.
Requested. Denied. Think about it. Just think about it.
You know what? Okay, I'll consider it.
Yeah, sleep on it. Oh, okay, you'll consider it. Okay. Yeah, well, follow In Pursuit
Thank
of
you,
Nothing.
guys.
Yeah,
Yeah.
wait, hold on,
Oh,
hold
no,
on,
go. Sorry, I've interrupted your
just
thing.
it's all good. Follow In Pursuit
So.
of Nothing, just on all social handles. I mean, most people know that, so like you're not really interrupting anything important. And you can find me at Alex Pasillas on all the social handles. I mean, you can follow me if you want, I don't care. Do whatever you want. But yes, thank you again so much, Joel,
Thank
for
you,
being on.
guys, man. This is fun. Like I said, like let's talk. Even if we're not recording, let's talk movies.
Oh, fuck yeah. Oh, just
Let's do
yeah,
this.
for sure. Well, that will be a sode, another episode of IPN's Movie Night. Thank you everyone for listening. It has well, I think it's like episode 18, so like we're chugging, we're getting through a lot of
Nice.
episodes, so
Chug,
it's
chug,
been
chug,
great.
chug.
Thank you again everyone for listening. Tune in next week where we will be not talking about movies, and instead we'll be talking about boats and
Boats?
boats. Moats. Yeah, sure. Let's talk about moats.
Boats?
Yeah,
You guys give good outro and intro and stuff, man.
When I live in a castle, I do.